হচ্ছে ওয়েটিং রুমের কনসেপ্ট।
हेलो हेलो सर
हेलो
सर, वो सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ अल्फा वो एक बार और समझा दीजिएगा ना।
हाँ, और एक बार बोलो।
सिग्निफिकेंस जो लास्ट
आवाज कट रहा है क्या? बोल रहे
हेलो।
हाँ हेलो
सर, कल सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ अल्फा जो पढ़ाए थे ना लास्ट टॉपिक, उसको एक बार रिपीट कर दीजिए, अपना नहीं समझ में आया था कल।
ठीक है,
ओके सर, थैंक यू।
तुम सुनते रहो, हम बोल रहे हैं, ठीक है? बाकी लोग आने दो। हेलो, না না ঠিক শুরু হয়ে গেছে কি? হ্যালো, হ্যাঁ হ্যালো হ্যালো, হ্যালো
হ্যালো, ইয়েস স্যার,
তুম তুম শুনতে রাও, হাম বোল রে, ঠিক আছে? বাকি লোক জয়েন করো না, ধীরে ধীরে।
ওকে স্যার।
ये जो दिस इज द ये है तुम्हारा अल्फा, ठीक है? ये और रोल ऑफ फैक्टर। तो रोल ऑफ अल्फा अगर हम इंक्रीज कर रहे हैं तो क्या हो रहा है? व्हाट यू आर गेटिंग इफ आई एम इंक्रीजिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ अल्फा, टू थिंग्स आर ऑकरिंग। वन इज एज यू आर इंक्रीजिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ अल्फा, दिस विल इंक्रीज, दिस इज द रिक्वायर्ड बैंडविड्थ टू ट्रांसमिट द सिग्नल। ओके, सो एज वी आर इंक्रीजिंग दिस वन, दिस इज इंक्रीजिंग, so that is not the desired case, but as we are increasing the alpha we can see that pulse shape is changing. If the value of alpha is zero at that time, pulse shape is like this. If the value of alpha is towards one, that means increasing, then this pulse looks like something like this. That means pulse shape is changing. This pulse is not possible to generate practically. That means practically not realizable because of sharp cutting nature of the pulse, which is known as brick wall pulse. Okay, and this is possible to generate. So how we will get this one? If we are increasing the value of alpha towards one, but at the same time, if you are increasing the value of alpha at the same time, this bandwidth will increase. This is not the desired thing, but this is the desired thing. That means ISI will reduce if the pulse shape is changing from rectangular to some transition kind of pulse. So ISI will reduce. That is the desired thing. So we have to make, or we have to set the value of alpha in such a way that both the parameters will be adjusted. Both the parameter, that means required bandwidth and ISI will be adjusted. That is the in that way we have to set the value of alpha when we are designing any raised cosine pulse or raised cosine filter. Raised cosine filter means it's a filter which will generate raised cosine pulse. So at the time of designing of raised cosine pulse, we have to maintain a certain value of alpha so that the increment of required bandwidth and the decrement of ISI both should satisfy. That is the significance of alpha mainly. One second. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Is it okay? Hello. Is it
yes,
okay?
Sir. Hello.
Hello. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that is the.
Yes, sir.
Okay. That is the significance of alpha. Okay. Very few members are joining. Only 8. Hello, shall I start? Hello. Haan bolo. Keno ei password ta to ache tumi QWAX 6 blaster dekh লাস্টে দেখবে এটা আছে একটা ওই শিফট দিয়ে 6 প্রেস করতে হবে হ্যাঁ তো কোন তো প্রয়োজন হয়েছে জয়েন এইটাই তো পাসওয়ার্ড আছে তুমি ট্রাই করো এইটাই পাসওয়ার্ড আছে Okay, shall I start or shall I wait?
हाँ सर स्टार्ट करिए
ठीक
आने वाले आते रहें
Okay, last day we have started this duo binary and some condition was there of duo binary pulse or definition, you can say mathematical definition of duo binary pulse is this one. Okay, where the value of the pulse is 1 when the value of n is 0 and 1. And the value of the same pulse will be 0 for the other values of n. That is the condition. It is almost all sync function only. Okay, it looks like we'll show how it looks like. This is the block diagram of the generation of the duo binary pulse. Here you see some bits, beep will be there. Okay, BL is nothing but 1010 some bit stream. Okay, this is coming directly at the summer and the same thing is coming via some delay element to the summer and is summing up and some signal is generated, that is C suffix small l, and each this whole thing is nothing but your HIT. This is HIT. Okay. Now this HIT is what actually? It's a summation of this line as well as this line. That means this HIT is nothing but a summation of two things. One is your del T. One is your del of T minus TB. Okay. This is your del T, and this is your 1 bit duration delay. So del of T minus TB. That thing we are getting as your HIT. Okay. Now we are trying to derive some expression of frequency response of duo binary pulse. So to generate frequency response, we have to consider some time domain signal. So that time domain signal is nothing but your HIT. So for the derivation purpose, we are considering that del T and del of T minus TB is coming here. Both are coming at the input of the summer, and after summing up, we are getting HIT. So this is the expression. HIT equals to del T plus the delayed del T version. Then it's very simple. Apply Fourier transform on this. Del T will give you 1, and del of T minus TB will give you some e to the power minus j 2 pi f TB. Okay, that is the time shifting property. And due to the del T, again 1 is coming after Fourier transformation. Then some rearrangement of the equation. That's taking common something. We have something here, and this will give you nothing but if this is divided by 2, multiply by 2, then cos term is coming. Is that clear? This derivation is very simple. Is that clear? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. After this, what? This is your HIF. HIF is nothing but your this one at this point. HIT in time domain, HIF in frequency domain at this point. After that, what we have? We have some ideal channel. Okay, that means this signal is transmitted. This is the channel through which the transmission will occur, and the signal will be received at this point, somewhere here. Okay, so this is the channel. So we are considering that this channel is the ideal channel, and frequency response of the channel we are considering as HCF. HCH means channel frequency response in frequency domain, definitely. And definitely it's a filter, so it is having some frequency response, and the frequency response is nothing but it's this one, where you see this is your HCF will be your 1 during the value of frequency will be plus minus W. That means in this range, this point to this point. Okay, that means this kind of some pulse you have through which the signal is transmitted. That means this is nothing but your channel. Channel is having some frequency response. हेलो Hello, hello, are you listening, all of you? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Somebody is telling that. Okay, wait. Somebody is telling that they are unable to join. Password is only that QXL. Wait. हाँ क्या इससे थोड़ी होता है
मेरा नाम शो नहीं कर रहा है देखो ना
क्या हुआ सर
वेट ऑल ऑफ दिस समबडी इज जॉइनिंग शैल आई लॉक ऑल ऑफ देम हेलो
यस सर
वेट दे आर जॉइनिंग Hello, listen once again. This is a signal, HIT. That signal is transmitted through a channel. Always I am telling that channel is having some mathematical nature. Okay, so this signal is passing through this channel. And this HIT or HIF, whatever it is, whether it is time domain, whether it is in frequency domain, it's having some expression. And when this signal is trying to pass through a channel, then that particular thing, that is HIF, will be multiplied with the frequency response of the channel. So frequency response of the channel is nothing but this one. Okay, and mathematical expression of this is your this one. 1 for some time, 0 for all other values. That is why it looks like this one, this kind of something. So HIF is multiplied with the channel frequency response. Then we are getting something as HF, which is the output of the channel, HIF. Now, very simple. Two things are multiplied. That means HIF, we got some expression here. HIF is this one. दैट इज हियर दिस वन मल्टीप्लाइड विथ वन दैट मीन्स व्हाट एच आई एफ इज मल्टीप्लाइड विथ दिस दैट मीन्स एच आई एफ इज योर टू इन टू ई टू द पावर कॉस टर्म इज देयर समथिंग विच इज मल्टीप्लाइड विथ वन सो वी विल हैव दिस वन सिमिलरली एच आई एफ इज मल्टीप्लाइड विथ जीरो सो वी विल हैव जीरो हियर दैट मीन्स वेन एवर एच आई एफ इज मल्टीप्लाइड विथ द चैनल फ्रीक्वेंसी रेस्पॉन्स देन वी विल हैव दिस काइंड ऑफ सम एक्सप्रेशन एज एच एफ विच इज इक्वल्स टू दिस वन एंड जीरो ओके फॉर डेफिनेटली दिस टू कंडीशंस दिस कंडीशन एंड दिस कंडीशन सो नाउ दिस इज द Now, this is the final expression of or transfer function of duo binary conversion filter or duo binary pulse generation filter. Okay, which is your HF is equals to this one because the remaining thing will be zero. I think it's clear because two only just you have to remember very simple way two things that. This block, just to follow this block, we have something HIT. HIT is what actually? The summation of del T and del of T minus TB. Okay? So HIT is nothing but the summation of two things, this one and this one. So that is your this expression. After that, HIF. HIF is nothing but the Fourier transform on HIT. That means this one okay so after taking Fourier transform we are getting this expression as HIF okay now this HIF is multiplied with HCHF now this is the multiplication HIF is multiplied with HCHF. HCHF is nothing but 1 and 0. And HIF is nothing but 2 into e to the power cos term multiplied. And we have this expression, which is the frequency response of duo binary pulse. Let me ask whether it is clear or not. Hello, whether it is clear or not. Hello, reply something. Hello, whether it is clear or not.
Sir, एक बार और clear कर दीजिए ना वो join नहीं हो रहा था अभी just हम join नहीं कर पाए.
That means online classes is very difficult. No. Somebody has written
sir,
that.
वो error आ रहा था.
हाँ वो हम समझ रहे हैं.
Sir, host पे locked बता रहा था.
Once again, I am repeating the same thing. Very simply, try to understand that two things are there. One is HIT, one or HIF, and one is your channel frequency response. HCHF, this one. So what is HIT? HIT is nothing but the summation of these things. This is the expression now. Apply Fourier transform on this. We'll have something like this. Some expression of HIF. Now this HIF is what? Is passing through the channel. This is the channel. This HIF is passing through this channel. That means what? That means nothing but HIF is multiplied with the frequency response of the channel. Frequency response of the channel is what? Frequency response of the channel is nothing but this one. HIF is multiplied with the frequency response of the channel here. So what is HIF? HIF is your 2 into e to the power something into cos of some term. So whenever this term is multiplied with this, then this term is multiplied with 1 and the same term is multiplied with 0. So we will have this one as well as we will have this one as your HF. So this is the frequency response of duo binary pulse. Sometime it is coming in the exam, the derive the expression of duo binary pulse. At that time, you have to start you have to start from this block diagram. You have to do this much of 2-3 lines, then channel frequency response, then just multiply the things. That's all. It's very simple. After that, what expression we are getting? We got this one. Now just we will take three conditions. We will try to put, before that, we will take mod of this. We will take mod of this. If I am taking mod of this, some mathematics is there. 2 is as it is, this 2 is as it is coming here. E to the power term will give you 1. That you do. That is part of mathematics, how it is 1. Then cos, mod of cos is there. This term is there. Now, applying mod means we have something like this.
Sir, my voice is not clear, sir.
Okay. Up to HF it is clear. Up to this HF it is clear. Hello. This is HF is equals to this one. Now applying mod both side here and here also. We will have then this expression. 2 into 1 into mod of the cos term. So 2 into 1 into mod of the cos term. Okay. Then we are putting in the case of at the place of F as 0, as RB by 2, as minus RB by 2. 0, RB by 2, minus RB by 2. Okay. Now, very simple. Just I am going to put in this equation F equals to 0. So, this one F equals to 0. That means this will be your 1. So, 2 we have. Okay. That means this is your first case. When the value of frequency is 0, at that time, mod of HF is your having some value that is 2, some constant value. That means at the value of frequency is 0 here, we have some constant value here as 2. Okay. Similarly, we will take two more things. One is RB by 2, one is minus RB by 2. Now, what is RB? RB is nothing but data rate. Okay. RB is nothing but data rate. This we know. W equals to 1 by T. This was the condition. Try to remember. This was the condition we used in the case of raised cosine. Okay. Greater than equal to or greater than or less than. So we have taken for the case of greater than. Now what is the use of joining? Okay. So, just you put the value, okay, this is the W is equals to your 1 by TB. Now, 1 by TB means what? Nothing but data rate. Data rate is your RB. Okay, that means at TB, at this time, 1 bit can pass. At unit time, how many number of bit can pass? 1 by TB. So this 1 by TB your now data rate denoted by RB. Okay. So 1 by TB instead of 1 by TB, we are putting RB by 2. So now what we have? We have this expression. Okay. So we are trying to put in the place of frequency as plus RB by 2 minus RB by 2. this is the minus RB by 2, this is the plus RB by 2. So you see, if I am putting in this expression frequency RB by 2 and minus RB by 2, so for the first case, frequency RB by 2, that gives you 2 into cos of, very simple, pi by 2 RB into TB. So RB into TB will give you 1 from this expression. RB into TB will give you 1. So cos of something, cos of there will be pi by 2, that is 0. So amplitude is 0. Again, h of minus RB by 2 also will have something 0. Just you put the values, okay, and use this condition. So we can see that at plus RB by 2 and at minus RB by 2, the pulse amplitude is 0. That means what? That means duo binary pulse in frequency domain looks like this. Or in some other way, we can say frequency response of duo binary pulse is this one. Okay, is this one. And this expression you can write down, that the, as we know, frequency response in frequency domain, impulse response in time domain. So in the time domain case, the impulse response is this expression. Just you remember this expression, where you can see that t minus 0 by tb, this term is t minus 0 by tb. Here t minus tb by tb, that means sync will exist here, t minus 0 and t minus tb. For both the point, amplitude is 1, and the sync function now modified into duo binary pulse, which is having impulse response in time domain P3NT equals to 1 for these values of n and 0 for other values of n, and it looks like this one. You see, when the value of n is 0, this is your 0. This is your n is 1. This is your n is 2. This is your n is 3. So whenever the value of n is 0 or the value of n is 1, at that time the pulse amplitude is 1. For the remaining time, pulse is 0. 0. Amplitude is 0. Amplitude is 0 for these cases. So this is the most important part of duo binary. Okay. Hello. Are you listening? Anybody? Hello. Hello. Divyangshu, Rajkamal, Arif. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Are you listening?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. One second. Let me ask one thing. Who is this Mac? Response Mac. Please response Mac. Hello. Who is this Mac? Okay, hello. Hello, we are Rajkamal Arif. I'm telling hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, class will continue. Okay, it will be disconnected sometime. Okay.
साला पबजी में एक दिन डूब गए तो देखिए पबजी में हम लोग।
हेलो
यस सर
क्लास विल कंटिन्यू
यस सर
इट विल बी डिस्कनेक्टेड देन क्लास विल कंटिन्यू वन न्यूमेरिकल वी विल
सॉल्व ओके सर ओके सर
आटा का दाम 5 रुपए चल रहा है देखते हो 8 रुपए तक का दिया है इतना दाम बढ़ा रहा है
Okay. Today we will solve one numerical on this duo binary signal. BL is the input binary bits. BLP is the amplitude of voltage
assigned. Sir, your voice is not coming properly.
Okay, listening. My voice is okay now. Hello. Voice is going.
Yes,
Hello?
Sir.
Okay. Today we are going to solve one interesting numerical. That is your. We have some bits which is coming